Welcome to the Plan B channel, where we provide information about HIV treatment that is up to date, unbiased and accurate, whether you're newly diagnosed with HIV or whether you've been living with HIV for some time. My name is Ben Plumley and I am a global AIDS advocate and strategist and passionate about making sure people with HIV have accurate information about HIV so they can live long, healthy lives. In each episode, we cover one specific issue, and today it's going to be Efavirenz. I'm joined by Dr. Royce Lynn, who is an HIV specialist from the United States of America and is associate clinical professor at the University of California in San Francisco. Dr. Lynn, welcome to Plan B.
Thank you, Ben. Happy to be here.
So one of our patients is asking about the different dosages of Efavirenz in HIV treatment. They have seen that there are studies suggesting that new low-dose regimens can be effective as the more traditional higher doses of Efavirenz in HIV treatment regimens. What is your opinion on this, and how do you advise patients?
Yeah, so Efavirenz is a very powerful and effective HIV medication, but it does sometimes come at the cost of some side effects for some patients. Some people may develop central nervous system side effects such as vivid dreams, abnormal sleep. So that's the context behind the reason why lower doses of Efavirenz have been considered. And you're right, Ben, that research has shown that the lower dose of 400 milligrams seems to be as safe and effective as the higher, more traditional 600 milligram dose. However, there hasn't been a great deal of reduction in terms of the negative side effects of Efavirenz, even on the lower 400 milligram dosage. The way I think about this, Ben, is that if someone's having side effects to Efavirenz, rather than looking at switching to a lower dose, I would just switch to a different class of medications that is not associated with the side effects that sometimes can be associated with Efavirenz. I think that's a cleaner way. Particularly since that the lower 400 milligram dose, many people continue to have side effects even on that dosage.
So if people are thinking about changing from Efavirenz, what are the kind of drugs, the alternatives that they might want to be considering in discussing with their doctor?
In terms of switching from Efavirenz, what are some of the other options? Well, two of the options that most HIV doctors would think of would come from two different classes. So Efavirenz belongs to an HIV class called NNRTIs, non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. So we can go to a different class, such as the protease inhibitor class, and choose something from that group of medications, or to the integrase inhibitors, which are newer and part of the first-line recommendation regimens in countries such as the United States. So integrase inhibitors or protease inhibitors can be a fine alternative to Efavirenz.
Well, thank you very much, Dr. Lynn. That's the end of this episode. In a moment, the screen will come up with information about how you can find out more about HIV treatment in your country, as well as how to contact us at Plan B. Thanks for watching.